Hi friends, today we can see how to print Fibonacci series in Java. We can see the steps now. This is an example of Fibonacci series. It is at start 0 is initialized, then 0 plus 1 is added here, then 0 plus 1 gives us 1. Then 1 plus 1 will be taken and it is added, so it will give the result of 2. Again, 1 plus 2 is added. That is the before number and this second number is added. So 1 plus 2 gives us 3. Then again, 2 plus 3 is added. The result will provide as 5. Then 3 plus 5 will be added and 8 will be printed. It goes on like this. The main logic is the number we are going to print will be the result of previous two numbers. Now we can move on with the steps to do this. First, we need to get the count of the Fibonacci series that we need to print. That is, here the input of number of elements of Fibonacci series that need to be generated is got from the user. Second, we need to initialize temp 1 to 0 and temp 2 is 0. That is nothing but 0 and 1. That is here. 0 and 1 is initialized and further steps is done. So after initializing, we will be using the third variable called sum equal to 0 with which we can add temp 1 and temp 2 and do the further steps. So we are using temp 1, temp 2, sum, the three variables. Now we need to print temp 1 at the first. That is, at first it will hold the value of 0 that will be printed. Then sum of temp 1 and temp 2 value will be stored in the value of sum. That is nothing but 0 plus 1. That will give us 1. Now the sum value will be 1. Next, again, temp 1 will become the second value. That is, according to our diagram, this will become temp 1 value and this one becomes temp 2 value. See, we can see with an example, you can understand better. Now, at starting, we will be initializing the variable, right? So, temp 1 is initialized to 0. Temp 2 is initialized to 1 and sum is initialized to 0. This is the step that I've been explained in this diagram. Then temp 1 value will be printed. Now at step 1, the value of sum will be updated with temp 1 plus temp 2. Now temp 1 and temp 2 will give the result. So temp 1 value is 0 and temp 2 value is 1 at the beginning. So this will give the sum value 1. Now we are going to update the temp 1 value with temp 2 value. That is, second value will be our first value and the sum that have been found will be our temp 2 value now. So at this point, temp 1 value will be updated with 1. Then temp 2 value will be updated with the sum, that is 1. So we will be printing the temp value 1. Before, we have printed the temp value 0. Now 1 have been printed. Next, we can move to next step. Yeah. Next, the sum value is again updated. That is, temp 1 value will be 1 from our before step and temp 2 value will be 1 from our before step. These two values added and now the sum value will be updated with 2. Again, temp 1 value is updated with the value of temp 2, that is nothing but 1. Now temp 1 value will be 1. Next, temp 2 value will be updated with the value of sum, that is 2. At this point, temp 1 value will be 1 and temp 2 value will be 2. Now again, we will be printing temp 1. That is, 1 will be printed. So until now, 0 is printed, 1 is printed, and again 1 is printed. Next, we can move on with the another step. That is, again, sum value will be updated. So temp 1 value from our before step is 1. Then 10 to value from our before step is 2. So 1 plus 2 will give the value of sum as 3. Now temp1 value will be updated with temp2 value. That is, temp1 will be updated as 2, and same wise temp2 value is updated with sum, that is 3. Now 2 is printed. Now 0, 1, 1, 2 is printed. In the same way, we need to print all the elements until it reaches the count. So now we can move on with our coding part and we can see how to achieve this. So to get the input from the user, we need to create the object of scanner. So scanner class is available in java.util package. We will be importing java.util.star. This indicates that the package util, the class under the util package will be accessible. So we have created the scanner class object here. Scanner, the object name equal to new operator, then scanner, the class name, and system.in is passed as an argument in order to get the input from the console. So at this point, it prompts for the number of elements that need to be printed in the Fibonacci series. For example, if the user have given the input of count, that is element as 3, then 0, 1, 1 will be printed. So we need to get the input of the count, right? So at this point, the count value from the command prompt is got it. So next int will get the integer from the command prompt and it will assign to the count integer variable. Next, temp1 value will be initialized to 0 as discussed, and temp2 value will be initialized to 1, and sum value is initialized to 0. So we will start printing. Here for loop is given from I equal to 0 until it reaches the number of elements need to be printed, that is provided by user at this point, will be checked. From 0 to the count value, the number of element will be printed. When it is 0, it will apply this logic that I have discussed and it will print the first element. Next, the value of I will be incremented and second element will be printed. The same thing will be achieved until the count value is attained. Now the Fibonacci will be printed. Now we can execute this program and see the result. Here it accepts the value of count. For example, I will give 15. The Fibonacci series until it reaches the count of 15 will be printed. Hope you understand this video. You can download the code from the Git. Have a nice day.